This is hardly a ho-ho-hum holiday film season. Now, if you haven't finished off the Star Wars series, you've got Cats to consider. And yes, it's a big mess. Even with names like Judi Dench, Taylor Swift, and Ian McKellen in the cast, it's one for the litter box. Because director Tom Hooper wasn't able to figure out how to transfer a beast from the stage to the confines of the big screen, well, it claws its way to some form of respectability. If you love the music and you want to sing along, go ahead. Others in the theater will be so busy gasping they won't mind a little caterwauling nearby. Now, two other films hold much more promise. In Uncut Gems, Adam Sandler reinvents himself as a bona fide actor, one who can handle the kind of stories Martin Scorsese dishes out. In this drama, directed by the Safdie brothers, Sandler plays a calculating jeweler who has a gambling habit, a failing marriage, and a customer in NBA star Kevin Garnett. When Sandler's Howard Ratner gets an uncut opal from an Ethiopian mining company, he thinks he can solve all his problems by selling it and using the money to bet on one of Garnett's games. Naturally, nothing goes right, and before long, Ratner is bobbing and weaving for just about everyone. Lakeith Stanfield is particularly good as his assistant, and Julia Fox and Idina Menzel are excellent as the women in his life. But it's Sandler who takes this and runs. The directors keep his moving at a breakneck pace and never let up until the last showdown. Uncut Gems is unnerving at times and always surprising. It may not be a relaxing film, but it's certainly an absorbing one. Greta Gerwig's take on Little Women bears watching, too. Giving those March girls a contemporary spin, she shows just how timeless Louisa May Alcott's story of ambition and dreams really is. Saoirse Ronan plays the Alcott-like Jo, who forcefully moves through the world of literature telling stories that have their roots in life with sisters Beth, Meg, and Amy. Now, stuffing this with big names, Gerwig gets a lot of mileage out of the story and a sumptuous look that will be remembered at Oscar time. Meryl Streep as the crusty Aunt March provides just enough spice to temper all the film's romances. Best of all, Gerwig gives her own spin to Little Women, infusing Alcott's personality in just about everything Jo does. Well, another run at Little Women was hardly the kind of follow-up you'd expect from Lady Bird's director. It's the perfect move. Best of all, Little Women is an ideal holiday movie filled with something to please just about everyone. Without question, it's one of the year's best films. With your movies in a minute, I'm Bruce Miller.